you've been following my channel for a few years, you may have noticed that I didn't make a review for 2020. While these videos have become a tradition for me, last year felt too heavy to try to find positive moments with the amount of intense pain and loss surrounding us all. I hope to never diminish the tragic realities of this past chapter of life, many of which still continue on today. But this year, I'm determined to try to search through the rubble of this global roller coaster and uncover some beautiful moments, memories, and lessons learned along the way. As usual, let's start from the beginning. 2021 started off in California as usual, as I was home with family for the holidays, and I rang in the new year with friends from college and then made my way back to a very snowy New York. To be honest, it was a pretty bleak winter as things were still closed down, so I spent a lot of time just inside reading, watching TV, working, and trying to stay sane. Things started to look up as our lease came to an end, Natalie and I found our dream apartment. While I wouldn't recommend moving in the dead of winter, I quickly learned that having more space to stretch out and call home is such a life changer. And it feels like a night and day difference, and I'm still in love with this apartment today. Once the news of the vaccine came, I signed up as soon as possible. Getting that vaccine felt like receiving a new lease on life, and I cried with joy and relief on my walk home. Clearly, the pandemic journey was and is far from over, but in that moment, it felt like a massive weight was lifted off my shoulders. And I'm forever grateful to all the researchers and healthcare workers who've sacrificed so much of their lives to get to this point. The monotony of life on lockdown was brightened by a stunning road trip around Utah, a visit to snowy upstate New York, and the chance to finally host dinner parties again and invite friends back into my home. Once it started to warm up, there were countless park picnics and museum visits and eventually even parties. I don't think I will ever forget the first night I went out. I've never really considered myself a partier, but getting to dance under a disco ball around strangers to blasting music for the first time in 15 months was absolutely exhilarating. Summer was honestly radiant. It was full of warm days as we tiptoed back into a new sense of normalcy in the city. I reunited with friends, I definitely overspent my dining budget on many outdoor meals. We fared to the beach, drank on rooftops, and danced all night. It finally felt like things might just begin to be alright after all. While the summer did have many beautiful, heartwarming moments, it was one of my hardest. My long-term relationship ended and I struggled to find my footing. So once Europe gave the green light to American travelers, Ashley and I planned a last-minute trip to the south of France to explore the coast. I'm incredibly grateful always to be able to travel, and we really made the most of our time there. We basked in the Mediterranean sun, talking for hours, basically having therapy sessions together. It was everything we could have hoped for a trip of healing and exploring on the French Riviera. Soon after, I was invited at the very last minute by Mini to fly to Munich, Germany to learn about their cars and the company's commitment to sustainability. Off to Germany I went, where I got to experience these stunning cars, I made new internet friends, and I'm still mind-blown by this opportunity. In September, I saw live music for the first time in 2 years at the Firefly Festival in Delaware with Natalie. I'm obsessed with live music, so this was incredible. We had the time of our lives running around, seeing musicians I've dreamed of seeing for years. In October, life finally slowed down a bit, and I got to soak in as many memories with my friends as I could. I celebrated my 25th birthday early in November in New York City by hosting a party at my apartment and inviting all my friends in the city to stop by, and I was so touched by the amount of people that showed up. It really felt like a testament to my 3 years of really intentionally working to build community and friendships in this city where it definitely does not always come easily. Then the perfect storm happened when Gabby, Ashley, and I booked a month-long visit to work remotely in Paris. Leases ended, jobs were remote, and we decided if not now, then when. My favorite moments were the simplest while we were there. It was taking breaks from work to walk along the Seine together, getting late-night falafel in the Marais, or just journaling in the many different gardens. We even had friends visit from New York. We had a very American Thanksgiving in our apartment, and it quickly felt like home. In the beginning of December, our apartment lease in France came to an end, and I spent some dreary days in New York City before flying back for Christmas to see my family. So, now, keep in mind, of course, that was my collection of highlights. This has been a difficult year otherwise. 2021 was a challenging year for me and, of course, millions around the world. I feel like my identity was really tested as I was slowly forced to reshape and redefine who I see myself to be. Though I experienced incredible opportunities and friendships that I'm forever grateful for, there were still a lot of chapters that felt like a dark cloud was hanging over me that I simply could not shake off. When I reflect back, this year was covered with a thick layer of self-doubt and anxiety, as well as accelerated growth. I found myself constantly asking, what is my purpose? Am I heading in the right direction? Is what I'm doing worthwhile? These questions and insecurities left me feeling vulnerable and destabilized, but instead of running away from them, I looked inward and really trying to lean in. Months of self-reflection and journaling and long conversations with loved ones have taught me a few things this year. Even though we naturally seek the avoidance of pain, it's crucial to persevere through discomfort to discern what will and what will not serve us in the long run. Sometimes this means letting go of certain comforts or patterns where it's time for it to be replaced. What are you holding on to that no longer serves you, as difficult and painful as it might be to release? Often it's enough to simply muster the courage to move forward just one slow step at a time. As difficult as something may seem, it too shall pass. The beauty of annual reflection is not just observing the growth we experienced, but also recognizing how the repeated ripples of anxiety can smooth out over time. Things that feel all-consuming at the beginning of the year can really work themselves out by the end. It's been a season of untangling, redefining, setting new boundaries and expectations. Through healthy habits like daily exercise, reading each week, journaling, and other routines, I was able to keep working on myself. Instead of finding my worth in others' opinions, I learned that the ultimate power rests in going deeper into yourself to discover your own intrinsic value. Rather than seeking that validation from external forces, I learned to start believing that my own opinion and the way I view myself is what matters most at the end of the day. Are you investing too much time in what others think of you? I've learned to let go of so much this year. I learned to let go of control of certain beliefs and ideas that no longer are serving me, listening to what others say instead of listening to myself. It's your life, so you get to decide what gets to stay. And I learned to extend myself forgiveness and kindness each time things didn't go as planned. This year, I really grew closer to my friends more than ever. I learned that community obviously does not come naturally, but putting in that work can cultivate the most incredible circle. I mean, they say you're the average of the five people you spend the most time with, so if this is the case, I'm grateful to say I'm surrounded by some of the most incredible, crazy, kind, intelligent, diverse, and creative people. This year really felt like friends turned into family. Depth takes time, and this year watered the roots that have been planted over the past 3 years and have given me some of the most loving and nurturing friendships. Who composes your inner circle? Who do you want to attract? And lastly, I know it sounds dramatic, but turning a quarter of a century old, I feel like really held a certain weight to it. Something about it felt meaningful in a way that my birthday hasn't felt in years. I think it kind of woke me up to the longevity and beauty of life. Each day is a gift. I joke I have what I like to call ticking clock syndrome, where it perpetually feels to me like there is a watch hanging over my head and I can hear the toll of the bell as I grow older. There's a deep need to accomplish certain things, reach certain goals, live out certain experiences before it's too late, and I've reached a certain age limit where it's no longer acceptable or simply ran out of time, especially as a woman. But the last 2 years have taught me to just slow the hell down and let go of my need for control. There's so much more to your life than your 20s, so don't be so hard on yourself. Trust me, you're enough as you are right now. Redefining success was such a crucial step to me this year. What does that look like to you? Is the job title you have, the plaques on your wall, the money in your bank account, numbers on your social media platforms? To start to figure out what a successful life might look like for me, I asked myself what my top five values are at the moment. I value freedom, independence, deep connection to community, lifelong learning, having a life of joy and fun-filled experiences, adventures, and using creativity for good. Along the way, learn to feed your soul and make yourself your own home. So, 2021, you were painful as hell at moments, but I'm thankful for the lessons that you've extended. I questioned everything, I learned to go inward, I saw the value in deep and loyal friendships, and I really redefined what is actually important and matters. I hope you can do the same.